How many wrinkles in a pickle? How many hairs in a head? How many waves in the ocean? How many crumbs in bed? But last but not least, but baby, most of all, why do I mumble every time you call?
You broke up? You can't break up. I just posted the whole city.
Oh, don't give me that shit. You just did that for your design class.
Yeah, but you have to play or I don't get credit. They check. I'm serious.
Was it a total adrenaline rush?
I guess. I mean, I didn't even really want to get it pierced. I had a gift certificate, and I couldn't find anything else to buy in the store.
You should come check out my performance piece at the Odd Fellows Hall. It's called My Father Used to Fuck Me.
God, yeah, I'll try to check it out. It sounds intense. I'm sorry that happened to you.
Oh, no, it didn't. It's just acting.
Oh. Well, what does your father think of it?
He hasn't seen it yet. So, you think the title's too strong?
No, it's cool.
Well, I mean, if it's, I'm just saying, it's just a title.
I mean,
too much, people are going to kind of...
No, I think it's
matter.
Cool.
Okay.
I'm not selling these. These aren't the regular 501s. They used to be my dad's. They're worth like $5,000 in Japan.
I have a friend who's kind of famous in Japan, but she never goes there.
No, I saw him speak at Evergreen, though. You know, he was talking about how, like, even though we think we vote for president, it's really the newspapers that control, you know, like all the money that, like, you know, when, say, you make a decision, and let's say you think America is a free country, right? Well, he was saying something about how I was kind of stoned.
He made both those films for like 700 bucks, charged them on his credit card. I hear he got a 10-picture deal.
Soma. See, I call it Soma. It's a site-specific minimalist installation going up at the Espresso Cart on 5th and Pike. Now, you should come check it out.
I don't know. Kind of busy.
Oh, come on. I'll give you a free latte.
Hey, you going to the Swerve the Manic Dump Truck show?
I can't go to their gigs anymore.
No way. Why not?
Steve, their guitar player, he gave me his leather jacket, and now he wants it back.
That's so sad.
You do make copies here, right?
No. I'm sorry, this is strictly a guns and ammo store. Can I show you a weapon? No, I'm sorry, I'm just kidding, actually. Can I help you with something?
What color paper? You see, I need something. What are my paper options here? I'm just not sure.
Okay. You can choose from anything in this book. These are an extra 5 cents per copy. I would stay away from these pinks, especially this one. It's giving me a headache. Don't use this.
It's important that the color be visually assaultive. The flyer is for a musical that I'm writing about the bombing in Waco, Texas.
Like the one I saw at Velvet Elvis last month?
What? That's okay. And that's cool. Because I'm also writing a graphic novel based on the Marquis de Sade's 120 Days of Sodom.
Great.
A lot of connections down at Fantagraphics. I'm pretty confident about publication. So, I'm always on the lookout for models with interesting bodies. Here's my card. Perhaps you'd be interested? Oh, but the number's been changed. My phone's been cut off. But you can still reach me by my pager.
I'll tell you what. Why don't I put it in this bowl here, and if we pick it out at the end of the week, you get 100 free copies. That should give you time to rework the whole Waco thing.
So, I've seen you around, haven't I? Maybe at Linda's or Moe's or maybe the Comet. Yeah, but you haven't been around for a while. What have you been up to?
I've been working.
Here. Or not? That's cool. That's cool.
No, I've been doing my work.
Great. What do you do?
Hey, when you're done with that customer, can I have a word with you?
Hey there, hey Antoinette, heavenly hang of the hot rod set.
Okay, it's like this. You know how the Aborigines believe that a photograph steals your soul? Each picture extracts just a tiny bit, is how I understand it. The people who said that were talking about those old daguerreotypes, those beautiful silver photos. One of those would be worth a little bit of your soul. What do you think they'd think about these fucking copy machines? They suck out 100 pieces of my soul a minute. They're like a soul Uzi. But I'm out of the line of fire now. I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna get some work done, or I'm gonna kill myself. I pass this place where some friends of mine work, and against my better judgment, find myself parking the car. Definitely the hippest pizza joint in town. It's the kind of place where they fire the delivery boy for being on the nod at just one too many green lights. Getting close to 30 and still nowhere near that big record contract, these kids aren't really kids anymore. But somehow, having a tattooed, pierced, unwashed sociopath prepare your food seemed to catch on with the yuppies, and the place was always crowded. Sure, maybe my subculture has a few pathologies, but they're family, and just like family, I'm stuck with them. Anyways, I'd rather drink a beer with these fuckers than with my mom any day. Uh-oh, my friend Trish. She's pretty, she's crazy, and she plays drums in a rockabilly band.
Hey, mamacita! We just tried to call you like 5 minutes ago, man. Your roommate's slightly uptight. We're gonna drink some beer, play some air hockey. Angel's in the car. Come on, man. Make us laugh.
She's the kind of girl who's best friends with the guys because she can drink all their asses under the table. Angel's awake and bake, pedal to the metal rock chick. She probably got her first Kiss record when she was 9, and a million bong hits later, her ridiculously unlikely dream actually came true. She's a star.
No, you haven't heard.
I got married.
What?
I don't crack. What? Are you fucking kidding me? Who did you marry?
Wait, did you marry Steve? The guy from Swerve the Dump Manic Dumpster Gunt Bandit?
Swerve the Manic Dump Truck. No, Steve, no. I'm still seeing Steve. No, this is a whole different deal, man. Fucking weird. It was radical. This dude named Jamie, we hooked up on the tour. He's selling t-shirts for us. I've been knowing him a couple of years, the whole time we got a crush on each other, but he's with this really serious girlfriend, so, you know. So, right before he comes to work for us, they break up. Bang!
Whoa!
We start fucking like dogs, man, of course. Woof!
Wait. Where were you when this was happening?
Italy, Finland, Japan, you name it, man. Biggest tour ever. Mm-hmm. But I spent the whole time in the hotel room with Jamie doing speed and falling in love. It was yummy. I just got back 2 days ago.
She's clinically insane.
You
no
know,
problem.
That is always a factor in true love.
Darling. So seriously, are you like in love? Would you have to buy you like a toaster or
yeah,
a waffle man,
man. Go get me a toaster, man. I am totally in love. But the fucked up part is he's doing his doctorate at Yale on like moss or lichens or some such shit. So he had to go there, so I had to come back here. But before he got on the plane, we get on the tour bus. We got married by this guy who's a roadie and a minister. He's a roadie and a minister.
It's beautiful.
Yeah. Hey, what happened with you? Who's that dude you were seeing? What?
Kirk, yeah. Is it still called stalking, even if you like it?
Oh, no, honey, that's called a relationship.
Bitch, cunt! Bitch, cunt!
Do you want to be rich? Do you want to be a superstar? Well, honey, you already are. You already are. Do you want to be rich? Do you want to be a superstar? Well, baby, you already are. You already are.
Oh, look at everybody going to work. All the novelists, filmmakers, painters, rock stars!
Woo! Hey, fuck you!
They can't afford an office, but they can afford a beer.
Uh-huh.
I am so over white guys with dreads.
Hey, Billy Ray Marley! Don't you wish you could fuck me, huh?
Hello, officer. How'd you like a big old red lipstick ring around the base of your cock?
You guys, I just gotta make a quick stop at the Comet. I'm supposed to meet this kid named Buzz. It's gonna be one sec.
A quick
you seen the AC/DC tape?
What are you talking about, man? 1962. I'm 32 years old.
Hey, I'm sorry, but this idea is expired.
By 2 days.
Hey, I carded Neil Young last week, okay? It's the law. Hey, Angel's back in town. Couldn't live without me, huh?
You fuck me in your dreams, you better wake up and apologize, Travis.
Hey, Trish. Hey, Princess.
Trav?
Hey, Trav. Some things will never change. She said she might be stopping by here tonight. You gotta do me a favor. Tell her I'm in sound.
All right, Angel!
Hey! What the fuck is that guy's name again? You guys, I'm gonna go say hi to my friends and see if I can't find Chester. Is that cool?
Go, girl. We're gonna get some beer.
All right. I'll be right back.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you want a beer, Prince? It's my treat. I'm doing it. I'm doing it.
I thought this guy's name was Buzz. What is he? Drug connection or potential romance?
What's the difference? Red Hook okay?
Yeah.
The Comet. A hair museum packed to the gills with dreamers.
It's not what I really want to do. I'm just stripping until I finish my thesis.
Oh, what are you studying?
Feminist psychology.
Yeah, if I sign you guys to Dead Neighbor, basically you buy the studio time, the tape, The printing and packaging, then if I decide to release it, you come up to the loft with my apartment and office, and you assemble it and mail it out. And if you guys could set up kind of a tour and let me know where you're going.
I'm a painter.
Like a house painter?
No, I paint pictures.
No, really, what do you do?
No, really, I paint. I'm a painter.
That's great, but what do you do for money?
Fuck off.
Hang out long enough and they'll let you join the senior set.
Jimi Hendrix? Hey, I went to school with Jimi Hendrix. 6768 Garfield High School.
Trish, why are we here? Who are we waiting for? You know I hate this place.
Relax. We're here to learn the trade secrets of a professional slut. Watch and learn.
I remember.
Waiting week. Man! Don't play with the big boys now.
Don't worry, nobody's gonna notice them. Au contraire, he doesn't know. He's a very hot commodity in a small town. Fresh meat.
Very fresh.
If he's smart, he'll work fast where it wears off.
I'm deeply ashamed to admit I've had sex with at least three of the guys in this dive.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. I got a broken heart. That's all I've got. You made me cry, and I cried a lot. I lost your love, baby, thanks a lot. You told our friends as I was passing by that you're not sorry that you made me cry. You said I deserve just what I got. Well, if that's how you feel, honey, thanks a lot.
Can we leave now? I mean, like, right now.
They're looking!
I have to sit at the window. I get car sick.
Trish, where the fuck is the AC/DC tape?
I don't know, man. It was here 2 seconds ago, man.
And you are?
That's Gwen Pearson's, man. She sings with a pussycat. She's totally fucking rad.
Pussycats?
No, pussycats. Pussycats.
All right. D&D!
Truck it aside.
My fault, baby. My fault.
Drink a whole tub of your bath water.
Oh, damn. I swallowed that as well.
So, Buzz, where do you work?
Oh, well, I used to work at the Raging Records in Butte.
Butte?
Butte, Montana. But then I got fired for, like, totally bullshit reasons that weren't my fault. But it ended up being, like, the best thing that could have happened because I said, fuck it, you know? Fuck this hick town. And I took the Greyhound out to Seattle because my brother-in-law is the advertising manager at Sub Pop, and he got me this intern position, so...
Is that how you met Electra Woman and Dinah Girl here?
Well, yeah. I met Angel at a Swerve the Manic Dump Truck record release party. I really dig his band, you know, and she's just fucking rad.
Uh-huh.
Shit's really happening for me right now, you know? I just got a new space. Well, it's not really a space. It's kind of a space. There's three of us going in on it, but it's got a dark room, which is cool, because I was really thinking about going into photography.
Buzz, how long have you been in town?
3 months. How about you?
3 years.
Cool.
Does anybody have any gum?
Dude, does anybody have a fucking AC/DC tape?
Gum, no. I got a half a roll of life service I found on the floor. You want one?
Is it mint?
I can't really tell.
think it's fruit.
Oh, good. Give me one. I hate mint. My mouth tastes strange. I slept for 2 days, like 4 days ago. So what does that make today?
Angel. Who'd you guys open up for on tour?
Corrosion of Conformity, man. They fucked us so hard. They wouldn't let us smoke pot in the tour bus or in a hotel room. They'd kick us out on our asses in Finland or some such bullshit, man. Mike, their bass player, he's in the program. He's trying to stay out of detox for like the seventh time. Fucking drag. 12 steps to hell on earth, I always say.
Amen. Tell me about what the label said today.
Oh, yeah. They want us to open up for Guns N' Roses. I'd rather open up Boston. Trish, where the fuck is the AC/DC tape?
Give me 2 seconds.
Move it!
Trish.
Yeah.
Are you having fun?
Fuck yeah, cause I'm the destroyer!
Why? What? I don't know. I'm just kind of tired, I guess. I thought maybe I could get some work done tonight.
Princess, why don't you just fucking relax, man? All right, just chill out. Play some air hockey. Look, in a few months, Angel's going on a big tour. I'm probably going with her. You should come with us too. Take a break. Come party with us, man. Hang out a little bit. Probably have to sell some t-shirts or, you know, carry some shit around, but we're going to Italy and Germany and France, South America.
Trish, I'm not gonna sell fucking t-shirts. What's the difference if we're in Belgium or Berlin? We're not gonna see shit. All we'll see are hotels and deli trays and buses. Angel doesn't care about traveling. All she wants to do is get fucked up and get fucked. For all she cares, she could be in Tacoma.
And the problem with that is?
Problem is, I want to get some work done. I can't just leave. Stuff is starting to come together for me here.
What are you ever gonna do with all that stuff?
I end up sitting at one of those video games. I start imagining the talented artists who slaved away at their computers to make the little car burst into flames, and how we never know their names. And then I'm asleep. It's always been easy for me to sleep in cars, ever since I was a baby.
Almost a full bottle of rum back in my space.
I knew I kept you around for something. Beautiful. We swing by, grab the booze, and then we just got a lovely night out. Woo! We got signs in place. How's that sound?
We could go visit Jimi Hendrix's grave.
Fuck no. It's like 20 minutes away, and I'm almost out of gas. Buzz, where's your place?
It's kind of between... do you know how to get on I-5 North from here?
Let me think. Yeah.
We'll do that.
Jimi Hendrix grave, man. I swear, the worst thing about being a rock star is knowing that when you die, you got a bunch of assholes getting wasted on top of you for eternity. I'm definitely getting cremated. Poor old Jimmy, man. He's always got some fucking hippies and tie-dye puking all over him. You know, Travis chipped off a piece of his tombstone once with a hammer, brought it to practice.
That is fucked up and wrong.
I like to fucking kill him, man. I swear to God, the next time he nods off, I am not calling the paramedics.
Shut the fuck up, man. You love him to death. Give me smoke. Hey, let's go to Bruce Lee and Brandon Lee's graves. Right next to each other. Two for the price of one. Really? What a weird coincidence. How come?
Buzz, tell me which exit I gotta get off.
Hey, why don't we drive past Kurt's house? You guys know where it is?
Yeah, I know where it is.
Oh, did you guys know him and shit?
Yeah, we knew. Yeah, I guess so.
So why'd he do it? I mean, do you guys know he left a suicide note, right?
Yeah. About 3 albums worth. Okay.
I gotta get some smokes. You guys want something? Sugar, salt, alcohol, but I'll settle for a pack of cigarettes.
Hey, if I give you a dollar, will you get me a dollar?
Oh, we should go get some coke. We're gonna get that rum, man.
My bed felt really good that night, but I lay there awake for a long time. I was tired, but I couldn't shut my brain off. You know what I mean? I couldn't stop thinking about how old I felt. You know, if I live to be 100, I don't think I'll ever feel as old as I did that night.
Everybody was kung fu fighting. Those kids were fast as lightning. In fact, it was a little bit frightening. But they fought with expert timing. There were funky Chinamen from funky Chinatown. They were chopping them up. They were chopping them. Chinese art, and everybody knew their part.